This is your YouTuber Touring Junkies, live from the IBW Goa that's happening there. And yeah, as you can see, all the super bikes getting lined up, the clubs getting their own flag, bikes, there's a Harley. More to catch up, let's see soon. Ciao.
The results from the judges will be judging four bikes. So those results will be coming out tomorrow. We're going to find out which of those bikes that roll up on main stage is going to win the best mod bike. And now moving on to Leslie. Leslie is the fastest woman on two wheels. And if you boys thought, especially you, thought you could ride a bike fast, think again. Because Leslie has outdone many boys on the flat monorail on her motorcycle. Leslie, so good to see you here in India. What do you think about being here with so many bikers from across the country?
What an amazing experience. Everybody's been so wonderful and kind. Woo! This is an amazing I think this contest is going to be tough to judge. Look at the beautiful machines, the excellent craftsmanship. Very excited about this. What a great event. It's an honor to be here in India.
Okay, now Leslie, not only races bikes, she builds, she put a bike together. Now, how cool is that? Having a girl like Leslie on your team can be really, really helpful. Leslie, what did you race at the Bonneville Flats to beat the record and crack the world record and get yourself on the Guinness Book of World Records?
That particular motorcycle is a Hayabusa, Suzuki Hayabusa, turbocharged, lots of modifications. It actually has a big bore engine, so almost 2,000 cc's. It takes a lot to build this machine, so it's nice to see all the craftsmanship that goes into this custom timing. I do a lot of work myself, so I have a deep appreciation for the time spent and the effort that you put into a motorcycle that you love.
You know, you're a big inspiration to a lot of women who are getting on the two-wheel experience and riding the length and breadth of the world. A lot of lady bikers are here at India Bike Week. I just want you to tell these boys, what's the fastest you've gone on two wheels?
I have been 246 miles per hour. They are very cool.
This man here creates a beautiful bike. Reza created an amazing bike back in the day called Dabam.
Bike Week. I have Rajiv sir with me.
Oh, sorry. I would like to correct you. I'm Rakesh.
I'm sorry. I have Rakesh with me here, who has an Iron 83. Amazing piece of bike. Totally loved it.
We had one heck of a ride from
Bangalore to Goa. Pune. Yeah.
Sorry, Goa. It took us.
I corrected you.
It took us a lot of time, but nevertheless, the end result is good. That you can see over here.
So yeah, what we are going to do is we'll be going to our tent, and probably tomorrow we have our club parade starting at 6 in the evening. Amazing ride so far, amazing time with an amazing bunch of people.
Massive bike collections, all the super bikes that you see globally are also available here. Lots of global participants, it's truly awesome.
This can't just get better than this. Iconic 5, here it is. Amazing.
Thank you. Okay, welcome guys. Welcome to India Bike Week. And we've got quite a few surprises, you know, who have come all the way just to meet you guys. So the whole point of having a mega moto vlogger meet was these guys always have their own meet, but we just want to give them a platform to get all of them together. And so just wanted to bring all of these guys together, hear their stories, and do a little bit of panel discussion about motovlogging and the art of motovlogging, because this is something that's been picking up in India. I'm sure quite a few are motovloggers as well, or aspiring to be motovloggers. So we just wanted to hear from the horse's mouth, or the vlogger's mouth, to understand what their stories and what led to them to start motovlogging. So I'm just going to keep asking you guys questions, and we have a mic there. Keep asking around. So the first question is, what made you guys start photo blogging? I'll start with Augie.
Thanks guys. So I think for me it was mainly the awareness. I think when I started riding motorcycles, I found out that it was much more dangerous than I thought it would be. And not for anything else, but just purely because of the kind of road sense people had or lack on our streets. And for me, when I started seeing other people do it globally, like Roy Jordanian, Adrian Nickelodeon, Batman couple, I think there was some need to kind of knock some sense, for lack of a better word, into people on our streets and kind of give them an understanding of how to change it. Maybe this current generation is a little messed up, but future generations, the younger guys who watch our videos and probably learn the better way of riding from that can maybe make our own videos like today. As I said, we watched Baron von Grumble and Roy Jordanian. I used to watch Chase on Two Wheels, I guess you guys know him. He does motorcycle reviews. And then I thought I'll be too loud. Anyways, so then I started watching Gawky while I was having breakfast every day in my office. And then I thought, why I can't do? I can do the same thing in Bangalore, you know, one of the most populous places in India. So I thought I can make reaction videos and make it funny for everyone, right? Everyone is going from house to office and coming back and watching some serial and binge watching on it. So I thought I'll give them a serial to watch, which has become a click, apparently. So that's it. That's it.
English chalti hai, Hyderabadi chalti. Are bolo bade mein bolo. So रोज गाड़ी लेके निकलते थे कॉलेज को, उसके बाद फिर राइड्स पे जाना शुरू करे. एंड अब रोज रोडों पे अंगार लगा रहे तो कुछ तो कंटेंट भी दिखता ना. सो बेसिकली शेयरिंग आर नॉलेज, शेयरिंग आर एक्सपीरियंस व्हेन वी गो टू न्यू प्लेसेस, व्हेन वी राइड इन डिफरेंट टेरेन्स, व्हेन वी डू डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ स्टफ विद द मोटरसाइकिल. सो ऑल आर एक्सपीरियंसेस वी लव शेयरिंग इट विद यू गाइस. एट द सेम टाइम हंसाना भी पसंद आता आप लोगों को. So that's basically how and why I started, and it's been going good so far. Right, so I guess everyone.
You try numbering
it. I got it. You buy.
Alright, hey guys. So I started motovlogging because I thought, let's do something different, right? Because we have almost all the guys over here, and I had one tagline which is breaking all stereotypes. So I just wanted to take this thing forward by motovlogging, sharing my views, how it is different on a bike, you know, when a girl rides, what does she feel, what are the problems she faces. And yeah, I mean, it's a complete different feeling, you know, motovlogging. You connect with your subscribers, you get to know a lot of people, and it's completely a different feeling, and yeah, it's wow. So this is why I started motovlogging.
Because?
Boris! I don't need a mic, but I still use it anyhow. Alright, so my story is probably the most kind of weird story. What happened is that the day I bought my first superbike, I started riding early morning rides. You know, we all do it. I went onto the highway, and when you go on a 6 a.m. ride, it feels beautiful, right? You're on a beautiful highway. So I thought, I'm speaking about 2012,
was. I was thinking how to capture something which you love and just share it with other friends who are living in Bangalore, Bombay or Delhi. So I was talking to my friend and he said, there is something called GoPro, use it, put it on your helmet. I said, alright, let me try this. So I put that onto my helmet and I recorded a small footage. And I uploaded that onto YouTube. I did not even know what was motovlogging or anything like that. I thought YouTube was only video sharing website. So, I mean it is, but it on a personal basis. So I put it onto YouTube and then I shared that link to those only four friends. I got back to YouTube after a week and I saw I have 1,000 views. I don't have 1,000 friends. Where did this come from? Then I got to know Roy Jordan and others and all that. Then I kept doing it. Today I'm here with 600 videos. I don't know how I produce them. thank you everyone. Hello, thank you.
No, no. la la la. Tu plaza, Colombia, me gusta.
Freeze!
Di Balvin, Willy William, me gusta.
Freeze!
Los DJs no mienten, le gusta mi gente y eso se fue muy bien.
Freeze!
No les bajamos, mas nunca paramos, eso es tomado y blanco.
¿Y dónde está mi gente? Me falta mucho la tente. ¿Y dónde está mi gente?
Interesting and exhausting trip.
And yes, we did a 100-kilometer stretch all in one go.
That is not our achievement. We rode for 20 fucking hours at a stretch.
I'll be back. And yes, now we are attempting for a 167-kilometer non-stop. Truly excited. Let's see how it goes. Ellen, do you want to share anything before we head out to Bangalore for the final time?
Just I'm enjoying my tea. This is the second one. That's it.
Alright, over to Sai and other group. Anything for my vlog? Anything for the vlog?
No, I have a numb bum.
Same here.
Same here.
Nanda is doing all that. And our
look at this guy, Mr. Full of lustration, lustrated. What would he use for him?
He uses his armor to protect his virginity.
Yes. So his dress is complete.
See this. See this bugger. Where is he going? See this. Chehra chupa raha apna ye banda. Rajiv bhai. One final parting words before we head out to Bangalore.
Masti aa gayi, bas ab khatiya lagne ki jagah deri hai. It was one heck of a ride. Tired but still very much all experienceful. That's good.
All excited, all geared up for the 167 km.
It was like we do like a bottoms up kind of thing now.
As stated, bottoms up, and we'll see you once we head out to Bangalore and we disperse from there. Till then, signing off. I'll catch you later. Goodbye.